So Japanese bread doesn't serve the same purpose here as it does in European countries. That's a problem. I'm kidding. No.
No, you're not kidding. No.
Bread is a staple in like European countries. Like it's saying, I need it. I just need it.
I need it.
And in Japan, it's like a fucking dessert project. It's like a fourth grader's like, oh, let's spice it up. Let's put custard in the bread. Let's do all this weird shit. Let's put hot dogs in the croissant. And it's like, what?
Okay, stop. To be fair though, they're all pretty bomb.
No, I don't want custard. So I like this bread. Don't get me wrong, I like this bread, but I feel like something's gone wrong. So next to our house, there's this bakery, and they sell this really fucking good bread.
Yeah.
It's amazing. It's bread that's so good that you can just eat it with nothing on it. And I put stuff on it, like I put tuna and toasted it, and it made the bread taste worse. And I was like, you're in the way of the bread. This is the bread's time to shine. And so I ate this whole loaf of bread.
Yeah.
Problem was, the loaf costed like 1,000 yen. Which is like $10. $10 for a loaf of bread? Holy shit, dude, this better be diamond encrusted. Well, Jesus Christ.
I mean, if it's the main star of whatever you're eating, I could see why it costs $10. I don't know, I've never been, personally, you know, I've never been blown away by bread.
You ever been to Germany, bro?
No.
Well, there you go, that's German people, man, say what you will, they've got bread figured out, man. All the Germans watching this are like, hell yeah, we do. Yeah. You go to Germany, you get anything in their bakeries, it's fresh as fuck, and it's amazing. It's so good.
Well, then it just makes me want to go to Germany.
So I'm going to move to Germany when I'm done with Japan. Hi, Germany, please welcome me.
Just to eat the bread.
Oh, dude, pretzels alone? Holy shit, pretzels are
German
good,
food's
man.
Fucking-
Holy fuck.
Yeah, it's so good.
I feel like pretzels and- bread for me. They are like the side dish to whatever the main thing is between them.
Oh, he said it. I
need to have something with my bread.
You haven't had a good pretzel, man. A good pretzel will change
your
life,
man. A good fat, hot German pretzel with mustard.
Yeah, mustard's good.
You don't like mustard.
You can put cheese on it if you want. I think-
That's exactly it. I need cheese on it.
No. I was about to finish my sentence, guy. Let me finish, guy. A pretzel on its own, just salted lightly, man, with the salt, like little salt chunks in there. Mm. Man, you get a nice, bite of that salt. Yeah. Goes perfect with your beer, man. Yeah. And even in the morning, right? It's great. It's light. You can have half the pretzel. Leave it, man. It's going to be great later. It's pretzels.
We're not talking about like the tiny fucking pretzels.
The big boy.
We're talking about like the big German pretzels.
Tiny pretzels fucking suck.
Yeah, they do.
They suck. Like, dude.
It's airplane food.
It's a shitty cookie is what it is.
It all hits the same.
No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. And like, I think I've seen a lot on YouTube at least, like bread is like a huge, like it's becoming a huge culture here of like experimenting with it and pushing it and make it more like dessert like and what you can do with it.
Yeah.
And I've noticed there are a ton of bakeries that none of them do normal bread. It's just like, what weird fucking thing can we do with bread? No. I put life on the edge, Con. I'm not going to do it. I think someone said that on one of the episodes as well.
Every time I say it, I'm like,
now I've noticed it. I can't not notice it. I'm just
fine. I'll put it down.
No, but like one.
I spilled some. Are you happy, God? I spilled some when I moved it.
For fuck's sake. Near the TV as well. What the fuck?
Right in
That's
front.
By your feet. Why would you put it by your feet?
Because then
I can't.
One thing though that I will say that I think a lot of people are going to find controversial is that the Asian bakeries in America, like usually the ones that are owned by like, you know, Koreans or Japanese.
Yeah.
I feel that the bread there is like way too sweet.
Yeah, it's so sweet.
It's way too sweet, but they don't really do that here.
It's like everything is a brioche. Like
exactly.
Every normal bread you get tastes halfway like to a brioche. It shouldn't. It tastes too sweet.
It's way too sugary. Like I don't even taste the bread anymore.
Yeah, and I've had a lot of Japanese people say like, do you think the Japanese food is too sweet? And I'm like, yes, it is too sweet. We have too much sugar in this shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
Because you eat a melon pan, don't get me wrong, shit's amazing. You look on the back, you have a fucking heart attack when you see the sugar. It's like 80 grams of sugar in the melon pan. And that's like what, like two Cokes and a half?
Yeah.
Holy shit. What the fuck?
But I would rather eat a melon pan than two Cokes
and a
half.
True. Because it's like, they make this bread, and don't get me wrong, it's as amazing as it looks in the anime. It totally is. And the first week here, I used to eat it nonstop. Because I was like, I'm never going to get fat. And then I had a scare when I looked at the back, and I'm like, oh, that's sugar, isn't it? Don't tell me that's sugar. Google Translate. Oh shit, it's sugar. Fuck.
And the fuck you were expecting?
You knew that a sweet thing would have sugar in it.
I didn't think when it said 82.
Surprise Pikachu face.
82 grams. Maybe it was protein. I don't know. Maybe it was protein. Maybe it was protein. Maybe the bread was very heavy in protein.
That's how all these Japanese waifu is getting swallowed. Right, that's fucking a melon pan.
And then I started thinking myself, I had this bread and I'm like, the bread tastes awfully sweet. And I did think, oh, it's kind of weird that it's, the topping is just sugar.
Yeah.
Huh.
Who would have thought?
That's weird. That's awfully weird.